Welcome back. In the last video, we set up that pickup mesh to represent our pickup within the level. Let me just go ahead and show you compiling within the editor so you can see how that works. So again, we did that very basic setup and we're going to switch back to the editor, click on this compile button, and the toast will pop up here in the corner. If for some reason you have an error during compilation, you'll actually be able to click on this and show the log and get some debug messages as well as switching back to Visual Studio and trying to debug it from there. So this is going to compile quickly, and then we will go back to, right there, just finished. And now we can add our activity code to the pickup. So we'll go back to Visual Studio. So again, we want all pickups to sort of have this state of whether or not it's active, and then ways to report whether or not it's active, and also change it. So let's start with our variable for whether or not it's active. And we are going to make this protected. And that means that we could change it either within this code class or in a blueprint or another code class based on this one. So if we wanted to override how create a blueprint based on pickup and then directly toggle the pickup behavior, we could do that. So it's going to be a Boolean. B is active. And this will be true when the pickup can be used, and false when pickup is deactivated. And again, that's very straightforward. It's just a Boolean. We'll say be true when pickup can be used and false when it can't. And we will go ahead and go to our constructor where we set the default values. And actually right here after the tick, we'll say that B is active is true. Basically that all pickups start active. And again, if you had a specific type of pickup where you wanted to start inactive until the character did something, you could make a blueprint or a code class based on this and override it in the constructor or the construction script because that variable is protected. Because it's protected, it can only be changed, again, by other types of pickups, not by say the character or the game mode. We would need to make functions for that. So let's go ahead and do that now. We'll do one to return if it's active or not, and then one to change whether or not it's active. So the one to return will return a Boolean, and it is active. You know, Boolean functions should really ask a question that has a true or false answer. Is it active? And just like we used the uProperty keyword before, or macro, we're going to use the uFunction macro on this function. And the keywords we're going to use here are blueprint pure, which I'll go over in just a second, and category, again, of pickup. And then the setActive is going to not return anything. It's going to be a void function, setActive. But it is going to take an argument of the new pickup state. And I'll go ahead and set that up here. This is also going to be a U function. But this one is going to be blueprint callable. And with the category of pickup. So the difference between blueprint pure and blueprint callable, they are both things that are defined in code but can be called from blueprints. Blueprint pure functions technically can modify things, but in general they shouldn't. They are run every time their output is used, so a blueprint pure function that pops something off a stack that is called twice, either with a loop or in two separate nodes, will pop two things off the stack. On the other hand, blueprint callable functions only run when the input execution pin is hit, and they save their results in the output pins. They can be used for not modifying calls. The difference between blueprint callable and blueprint function
Blueprint Pure functions means that expensive calculations that aren't expected to change frequently are better in Blueprint Callable functions than Blueprint Pure functions. But fast calculations that will frequently change are better to make in Blueprint Pure functions, or by adding multiple Blueprint Callable nodes to your graph.
Do you want to know more about using Blueprint Pure versus Blueprint Callable? We've got lots of documentation over basically how to write APIs for Blueprints, and definitely check that out. And real quick, while I'm thinking of it, let's, again, comment so that when we come back in a week, we know what this function will do, and it will return whether or not the pickup is active. And this allows other classes to safely change whether or not the pickup is active. Now, neither of these do anything right now, so let's go write the definition in the source file here. So, again, our Boolean for is active it is super simple. It is just going to return B is active. But setting it up this way with these public functions that manipulate a private or protected variable keep things sort of code safe, especially if you've got multiple people working together on a project and they may not understand, you know, the rules set up in code, or, you know, people trying to have different things interact together. So now our setter is, again, very straightforward. And it's going to take that new pickup state as an argument. And B is active is a new pickup state. But say you wanted to, you know, also print the new pickup state to the screen, or change how the mesh looks depending on whether or not it's active. You can handle all that in here, and it's a little bit more complex than just changing B is active, and so you wouldn't want to change B is active without those associated other pieces of code. So that looks like that's all ready. Let's go back and again, returns active state, and changes active state. Save both of those, double check everything is saved. There's our Boolean, our getter, and our setter. Now let's go back to the editor and compile. Okay, that just finished compiling. Let's now make a blueprint based on our pickup. So we're actually right here in the concept browser. You can right click on our new pickup class and create a blueprint class based on pickup. Let's call this, I was going to save this in a blueprints folder, so let's cancel really quick and go make that new folder. So right click on content, new folder, call it blueprints, just to keep everything sort of organized as we go forward, and then go back to battery collector, right click, create blueprint class, save it there in blueprints, and let's call this pickup underscore BP, so pickup blueprint. And create the blueprint class. So this is going to be the full blueprint editor, but let me just save this and reopen it so you can see something. So if I reopen pickup blueprint now, this is a data-only blueprint, and actually, because this isn't going to have any full node behavior, I could leave it in this state. So if you see, there's the static mesh, and I can actually go ahead and set that here to this cube. And save. And if I want to just drag the pickup blueprint here into the world, you can see it right there. Play, and hey, look, it's our new pickup right there, ready for us to interact with if it had any way to call that active changing function. But I do want to show you those two nodes that we made. So I will go back over here and actually open the full blueprint editor. So you can see this note that it's a data-only blueprint. So we only see the defaults, doesn't have any script or blueprint-specific variables. But let's go ahead and open that full blueprint editor. You can see some grayed out sort of template nodes, but really quick, let's just, you can actually see our pickup category here in the right-click context menu. So again, I just right-clicked and scrolled down until I saw pickup, because remember we put that pickup category on all of our nodes. And we see our is active, and go ahead and type pickup into search this time. That actually didn't search as much as I wanted, so let's go with set active. And we can see that here too. So this one was the blueprint pure, and so it doesn't have any execution pins. And this one was the blueprint callable, and it does have execution pins, so it can be, you know, specifically called, say, on begin play, if we wanted to have them be not necessarily, we could turn them to be not active. So we'll just delete that really quick, because we don't actually set up any behavior, but I just wanted to see you to see the difference between those two nodes. So just to wrap up, in these two videos, we made a very basic pickup in C++ and then made a blueprint to show you how you can set the variables defining code in the editor. In the next series, we'll make a battery pickup class that inherits from the base pickup and give it a little bit more functionality. Thanks!